हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वंस अगेन वेलकम टू दी स्टैंडर्ड 10 सब्जेक्ट मैथ्स। एज वी वेर इन चैप्टर 1 रियल नंबर्स, लास्ट टाइम वी हैव सीन द फंडामेंटल थ्योरम ऑफ एरिथमेटिक एंड यूजिंग दैट वी हैव सॉल्व एलसीएम एंड एचसीएफ टाइप क्वेश्चंस। आफ्टर दैट in that I have given you the homework also, like exercise 1.2, and you might have done because it was so related to the earlier classes, and by the factorization method we were calling at that time to find the LCM and LCM, and this is the name that fundamental theorem of arithmetic, and by that we have done the sums. Now the next in this chapter we have, after exercise 1.2 you will see in the textbook, it is revisiting irrational number. Revisiting, why it's so called? Because in 9th standard also you have some idea about rational numbers and irrational numbers. Here we are again visiting the irrational numbers. So we just recall the definition and some examples. So first you recall the rational number. Rational number is a number is rational if it can be written in the form of P upon Q, where P and Q are integers and Q is not equal to 0. This condition. If any number can be written in the form of P upon Q, where Q is not equal to 0, this is the condition. Because if you will take Q equals to 0, the number will be infinite, means undefined number will be. So this condition is compulsorily we have put. Now, so some examples we have 1 upon 2, minus 2 upon 3. So many examples are there. You can write it your own. Examples not necessary to learn. To learn is to what is called rational number. It should be in the form of P upon Q with the conditions P and Q are integers, Q not equal to 0. Right? Similarly, the irrational numbers also we have understood. Again, recall the definition. A number is irrational if it cannot be written in the form of P upon Q. If it can be written in the form of P upon Q, rational. If it cannot be written in the form of P upon Q, where P and Q are the same conditions, integers Q not equal to 0, then that type of numbers are called irrational numbers. Right? So some examples we have, like root 2, root 3, root 5, and so on, all root numbers, minus root 2 upon root 3 also. This also the decimal expansion form, it is given 0.10, 100, 100. So just recall here that this number is non-terminating because it doesn't have and non-recurring also because no pattern is repeating here. So non-terminating and non-recurring. So, whole and whole, what we can write at conclusion, that root P is irrational, where P is prime, like this, P is prime, 2, 3, 5, all prime numbers, if the prime numbers are in root, we can say directly that they are irrational numbers. So, I think you understand the rational and irrational. Actually, you were having the 9th standard, once again you have to write it and understand. Once again, you can write the example and this example also of irrational. So it will be very clear in your mind and you can learn it, you can understand. Now the next in this, we have theorem 1.3. Theorem 1.1, Euclid's algorithm we have seen. Theorem 1.2, fundamental theorem of arithmetic we have seen. Now next we have theorem 1.3 is, let P be a prime number. Prime number means like this, 2, 3, non-divisible numbers. Let P be a prime number. If P divides A square, then P divides A also, where A is a positive integer. To understand this theorem, we have taken some examples. Like first example, 2 divides 16. It's a fact. 2 divides 16. So 2 divides root 16 also. Root 16 means 4. 8. So 2 2 divides 4 also. So do you understand? If P divides A square, then P will divide A also. It's compulsory by this theorem, and you can understand this is the fact also. One more example, if you see, if 3 divides 36, then 3 will divide root 36 also, like 6. You can see 3 divides 6 also. So this is the theorem we have to learn and understand now, new theorem for us. And now we will have two that type sums in which we will use this theorem. What is this theorem? If a number divides some number, then that number will divide its root also. Again, if P divides A square, then P will divide A also. This is we have to understand, we have to learn for the next coming examples and questions. Thank you.